Morning, everyone. I hope you're doing okay during the lockdown. Yesterday, we were thinking a bit about church as a body. Well, today we're going to think about another picture that the Bible gives us to describe church, and it's that of church as a building. Not literally, of course. The Bible doesn't ever anywhere describe the church literally as a building, but it is a really helpful picture. The word for church in the New Testament is ecclesia, which literally means a gathering or an assembly. In other words, a group of people. And God, the great architect, if you like, has plans for his people. If you like, the church is God's great building project. And if you're a follower of Jesus Christ, then you're part of his project. What does that mean for us? Well, we see more of this building idea in Ephesians chapter 2. If you've got a Bible, why not open up with me to Ephesians chapter 2, and I'm going to read from verse 19 through to verse 22. This is Paul writing to the believers in first century Ephesus. Here's what he says. Consequently, that is in light of the gospel, you are no longer foreigners and aliens, but fellow citizens with God's people and members of God's household, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone. In him, the whole building is joined together and rises to become a holy temple in the Lord. And in him, you too are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his Spirit. Paul is writing here to a Gentile church in what's now Turkey, to you and me, and to the Jews, who were the people of God. The Gentiles were foreigners and aliens, as he describes it here. But now, says Paul, through the blood of Jesus, they've been welcomed in as members of God's household. And our question this morning is this: what is this household built on? It's a household made up of Jew and Gentile. It's a household made up of people from different walks of life, different backgrounds, different cultures. But what's it built on? For many of us, I guess, over the past 9 months, COVID has rocked our foundations. Many of us have had to question what our lives are built on. Well, what about the church? What is God's church standing on? Well, have a look with me at verse 20. Because this household, says Paul, this community of believers is built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone. Any builder will tell you it's the cornerstone that holds the whole structure together. It's the first stone that is laid by the builders, and every other brick or stone, if you like, finds its place in the structure in relation to the cornerstone. Paul stresses it for us in verse 21. In him, the whole building is joined together. Verse 22, in him, you two are being built together. You see, when we are united with Christ by faith, we are also united together. We are joined together in him. The church, if you like, this building project, it's a corporate thing. We're in it together. The Christian life is not an individual thing. It's a team game. We're in it together. And the foundation is very clear here in Ephesians 2. It's all built on Jesus. And here at St. James, that means for us, in everything we do, we trust Jesus. We trust him for our salvation. We trust him through COVID. We trust him in lockdown. We trust him for all our needs in the year ahead. It also means that in everything we do, we proclaim Jesus. We long to see every life transformed. How will that happen? Well, we will keep preaching, proclaiming, and talking about Jesus. He's the foundation on which our church is built. And now, we're a work in progress. We're not finished yet. We're a long way from perfection. We know that, of course, just by looking at our church. We've got a long way to go. But we also know it because Paul says here in verse 22, you are being built together. That is, it's an ongoing work. This project isn't yet finished. But if we are a church that is built on the foundation of Jesus Christ, well, then look with me at verse 22, because I think this is really exciting. We can be confident that if we are being built on the foundation that is Jesus, we will become a dwelling in which God lives by his Spirit. And that will just be a wonderful church for us all to be a part of. So let's pray then that with Jesus as the cornerstone, we will be a church with firm foundations, if you like, a building with a solid structure. Because that will make us a church that is built to last. Even in a changing world, we'll still be standing when Jesus comes back. It'll make us a church that can weather the storm, whether that's in a COVID world or just a hostile culture. We will be able to withstand whatever is thrown at us. And I think it'll make us a church that is marked by humility, because we will know that if by God's grace things grow and people get saved and we begin to see lives being changed, we will know that it's all because we're a church built on Jesus. We won't claim any of the glory for ourselves. We'll just know it's because we're built on a firm foundation. Let's pray then that we would be a church built upon Jesus and standing on his gospel of grace. I'm going to lead us in prayer to do that now. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you that our church stands on Jesus Christ as the chief cornerstone. And we thank you that in him we are joined together with one another, that in him we are being built together to become a dwelling in which you live by your Holy Spirit. And we pray, Father, please, that your Holy Spirit might work in our hearts day by day to draw us closer to the Lord Jesus Christ and closer to one another, that we might be a church with firm foundations, built to last, able to weather the storm, and would people see in all that's happening here at St. James that we stand on Jesus Christ. In his name we pray. Amen.